Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome to a very interesting round table, if you will, rectangle table, fireside chat, whatever you want to call it. We are in Sweden and have an awesome opportunity here to hang out with the guys from FX Air Guns. And so we're going to talk air guns. First of all, Frederick, thanks for letting us come into your house. I have to take the old shoes off here, so if you see my yellow socks, don't worry about it. It's part of the game here in Sweden. I want to talk to you guys about we do a lot of competitions. I think I met both of you actually first at a shooting competition.
Yeah,
you've done well. You've won a few competitions, EBR and others. You compete in a lot of them and
yeah.
have gotten close.
Yeah. Getting right. Some experience under my belt, yeah.
And Ernest, you being a gun know-it-all, you know how everybody wins or loses, but you've had some success in Chile, at Santiago, you did a competition and
yeah,
almost won.
I did some in Florida, yeah. I got two second places and I'm getting an itch, so look out.
Watch out.
It's just a matter of applying yourself, right?
Yes. Yeah.
So I want to talk about speed silhouette, gunslinger as some people know it, depending on what competitions you go to. What is the key to winning a competition like that's based on speed? Is it the gun? Is it the person? Is it your cocking finger trigger?
What it is is people tending, aiming too long.
Okay.
You get the gun moved and you start shooting and you focus on next target even before you hit the first one. Always have next target in your mind. Mm-hmm. So you're just constantly moving, bang, bang, bang. And if you do it completely right, it's going like, wow, everything but. But you're missing every now and then. Yep. And when you're missing, you're losing the momentum, so to speak.
And the confidence.
And if you miss too many times, then you're done.
Yeah, it's completely different than like a bench rest where you're kind of competing with yourself.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and there's also adrenaline. It's like you don't have to hit the target dead center if you just hit it.
Well, if you just hit it, it spins around and stares at you.
It could happen.
Like, oh, come on.
It could happen, but that's not very often. Yeah. Happened to me, happened to several other people. Uh-huh. Yeah, for sure. But you have to move fast because if you doesn't move fast, someone else will.
Sure.
Yeah. So, and I'm there to winning. I'm not gonna sit there and try to be. Oh, it's fun to be in the party, you know.
Yeah. No. But when you go too fast, you get too anxious.
Yeah.
You get this.
You have to have the balance.
So a lot of adrenaline.
You gotta know your scope. I mean, between the furthest and the nearest target, you gotta zero your target between halfway. Mm-hmm. So. It could be a half mil dot between the two targets, the furthest and the closest. So you know you shoot right away, you know where the mil dot's at, and you're gonna hit your target. If you take your time and pull. If he misses, you're gonna be ahead. You take your time.
Now what about these single loading guys though? I mean there are some guys out there, when they single load, it's the fastest. I mean their fingers moving up and down, putting pellets. I put it in backwards, I throw it through the hole between my scope and my gun. I mean this is a talent that people spend at home. But practicing loading, am I right?
But
I get the idea. It's trying to level the playing field because the technology.
It's the one who's fastest with his finger is going to win the thing.
Sure.
Yeah. No, I don't. I don't count that to be a.
That's not. You say load them up and let's roll.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
You can't be moving the gun around while you're loading. You need to balance yourself. That's what you need, the magazine?
Sure.
It's a magazine.
Or bench rest, yes, you use a mag. Or you can single load when you bench rest.
You do extreme. Whatever you want.
So you would load the magazine first, put it in, and then go at it.
That's what I call in competition.
Yeah.
And everyone does it differently. You got to make sure you know your rules of the event you're in. There's different techniques to it. You can go farthest, front, back. It's easily the single most easy to understand from a spectator standpoint event. And it happens quick, so you can sit back, you understand what's going on, you understand clearly who won, what went wrong.
It's kind of the only...
Speed shooting is not about how fast you can take a pellet, put it in the breech, closing it, and bang. That's quite boring.
That's not the skill people come out to watch.
Put it in there and see who's the fastest shooter.
That's the skill. That's the skill that we're really...
The other thing is just... It's ridiculous.
I mean, I guess if you were doing a duel with a pistol, it wouldn't be very fun if you pulled real quick and then you had to load your gun.
Yeah.
That wouldn't be.
Wild West movie, come on.
Yeah, that would not be as fun. Bye. So what's your favorite competitions? I mean, because they say the speed silhouette is that's kind of the one spectator sport for air guns where it is fun to watch because you can see exactly what's happening. But as a shooter, what's your favorite competition to shoot?
Long range, extreme.
Okay.
If you know your gun, you know how fast it refresh and how when it recycles. Mm-hmm. Let's say 3 or 4 seconds is really consistent extreme spread. As long as you're dead center right on the crosshair, you pull, pop, pull.
You're talking about giving the gun a chance. The
yes, to be- I know the gun, how yeah. it recycles and what speed is most accurate. And when you, let's say 3 or 4 seconds, I shoot it through a chrony. I shoot it that fast, 3 or 4 seconds, I see the speed. And it really close together. Mm-hmm. If you wait 15 seconds, 30 seconds and wait around for the wind, that first shot is going to be always all the off.
It might go a little higher. Yeah.
Off.
Interesting.
If it's consistent, rip it.
Yeah. So you guys are both, you're talking 75 and 100 yard bench rest.
Yeah. Yeah. I
Jonathan, what about you? Is that?
The bench rest has something really special. It's just, the speed's a lot of fun.
But don't you guys get bored out of your mind?
Not when you're shooting it.
Really?
Oh, you get in your own little, you get in your yeah. zone. You got to find that peace and calm. Yeah. You got to block out everything around you. You hyper focus.
Man, I have
you're
not.
Taking your runs where you feel like the conditions are good. And you're
yeah.
like, yeah, go, go. And
I have not mastered that. I get so bored.
Yeah. And every shot on the target is like a shock to your body. It can be a
it's
shock
life
of
or death.
Positivity.
Yeah.
You know, oh, 10 yeah. eggs. Wow.
Or, I don't think I've ever gotten a 10 eggs. Maybe I don't know that
feeling.
Or a bad
shot is like, oh,
yeah, no worse than starting and you're doing your testers, everything's, I'm feeling good. Your first shot, 6.
Oh. Yeah. That's how mine starts, and I'm like.
Internally.
You drop everything, you know, sitting there.
You can always see the shooter. Is
yeah, yeah. If you don't trust your gun, forget it. You have to trust the gun and yourself. What you're doing is right. Mm. Whatever happened on that target is the wind.
Yeah,
if
it's
you
only
start
variable.
Thinking, oh, something wrong with the pellet, oh, something wrong with my gun. If you start thinking that, you're never going to score high. You're going to go halfway, half score, not
it says halfway,
score.
You're going to short yourself. If you had a 2 mil hold, 2 dot hold, you're like, oh, maybe it's just 1.5.
Right.
A lot of second guessing.
A lot of people, they're shooting in good condition. So they get really scared when it comes to win the competition. You know, they
sure.
are, wow, what's going on?
Well, especially if they make it to the final and it's 100, because 75 yeah. and 100 is a big difference.
It's a big difference. And they start questioning themselves and things like that. But if you do practice in the wind before the competition, you will know how, you know, it's just so crazy things going on.
What are some of the other fun competitions you guys have shot in that are different than the speed silhouette and bench rest? There's some other, isn't there some other stuff out there that's just more fun, fast-paced shooting that's exciting for everybody?
Well, I'd say even within speed silhouette, usually people are thinking everybody lined up, knocking down the four little, you mm-hmm. know, four rows of four. But there's like speed skills. They do that at the Utah competition, the yeah. RMAC. That's completely different. You got 10 stations. There's 6 of you, like a 6-man crew. You go to each station and you pull a chip to see who you're going against. And each station is different. Like there might be one where it's a little, you know, the rotating duck thing. How many can you hit in a minute?
Yeah.
There might be some where it's different yards where you have to go through them in order and
very carnival specific. Games.
It's like a speed skill
yeah,
thing where each one they're saying, here's what you have to do. You don't know going into it. You're like, and your gun's zeroed at 50, but you're shooting 75, 25. I mean, it's, mm-hmm. you have to really apply all your skills, but it's fun because you got
it's
a lot of camaraderie.
So yeah. It's so fun.
You got 6 of your buddies. You want to beat the crap out of them, but you're also laughing and helping each other.
Sure.
Yeah, it's fun.
So for the people out there that don't even know that these competitions even exist, what are the top, you know, 4 or 5 competitions that happen every year that people, if they like air guns or they like competitions, that they should just come and bring a gun and check it out just to be a part of it?
You know, my main one is going to be the RMAC. That's going to be the everything.
RMAC, that is the Rocky Mountain
Air Gun Challenge.
Air Gun Challenge. It's in Utah. It's in June-ish.
Yep.
And
so, what I understand, they actually have $10,000 there with my name on.
$10,000 prize money?
Yeah.
What?
First prize money. So I'm going to collect that. And also, there is other competition with $3,000 to $5,000.
Yeah.
I'm going to collect a few of those
ones
as well. So I'm just going to have a great time over there.
You know, the cool thing is, it's just now these competitions are starting to happen where there's about 4.
Yeah.
I know there's a Utah one. There's something going on in Chile.
What's the Chile one?
Chile's in November.
Uh-huh.
It's like a Chile air gun challenge. They're doing a similar
okay.
format. You know, there's extreme bench rest. There's a Pyramid Air Cup, I know.
Yeah.
So now there's 4 or 5 big ones, which is great. Our sport's growing. Competition is the basis of growing the sport. Serious money on the line.
Yeah.
I think more and more guys are getting excited.
All right, that's it. That's all the time we've got here for our fireside chat, rectangle table, round table discussion. Frederick, thanks for having us in your house, man. This has been good. Guys, I appreciate you doing this. Yeah, it's kind of a last minute deal. We were talking about all this at the table, and we thought we should talk about this at a round table. So here we are. If you want more information, go to AmericanAirGunner.com. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time. All right, yeah, I mean, so, well, practice and be better.
Get to know the gun.
Well, what I understand, you never felt any trust in any gun.
You haven't even shot the gun before.
But you never shot an FX, I realize.
So when
you start,
not.
You're going to fall in love.
I can't wait.
Your wife's going to have problems.